Welcome all of you. Today we will see how to use tables in OpenOffice Writer. So first of all, to open a table or to create a table, we have to click on the table menu and then we will click on insert table. Now how many columns and rows we want for the table, that we have to select from here. Suppose we want two columns and four rows. So I have taken two columns and four rows here and click on OK. So now this table is being made with two columns. These are the columns. This is first column and this is second column. And this is the row. This is first row, this is second row, third row and so on. So columns are vertical, rows are horizontal. Each small rectangular box of a table is called a cell. And suppose I am writing in the first cell, to go to the next cell, I have to press either tab or arrow key. So I am using arrow key here to go to the next cell. So now I am writing roll numbers in the first column and in the second column I am writing names. Okay, now if you have to add one more row, you can simply press tab, one more row will be added automatically. Okay, and suppose if you have to add one more column, suppose you want a column for class also. So place your cursor where you want to add a column, go to table, click on insert and then click on columns. Now it is asking you whether you want the column before or after the cursor position and how many columns you want. Suppose you want two columns after the cursor, click on OK. So after the cursor position, two columns have been inserted. Now suppose I want class also and marks, there are two columns I have added now. Similarly, if you want to delete any column or a row or to insert a row also, suppose I want to add a row on the top, so I'll go to the first row and then I'll click on table, insert, row, and before the cursor I want to add one more row, so I have added a row here. Similarly, if I want to delete a column, place your cursor, like I want to delete class column and click on delete, click on columns. Similarly, you can delete a row also by going to table, delete rows, and it will delete a row. Now suppose I want to add a heading mark sheet at the top of the row. Okay, so what I want is I want to merge all these cells so that my heading should come in the middle of all these cells. So go to table and click on merge cells. All these cells are merged. And you can press the right center alignment button for center aligning this text, that is a heading mark sheet. You can also change the font size according to your requirement. Okay, now we will see how to split cells. Like suppose if I want to split the cells of this particular column, I want to split this cell. So I'll click on table and then split cells. And I want to split it into two parts or more than that. You can select it from here, 2, 3, whatever value you want. And then you can select whether you want to split horizontally or vertically. I have selected vertically. So now it is split into two cells now. In the first cell, suppose I am writing the marks of first semester and in the second cell, I am writing the marks of second semester. So like that, you can also split the cells. Now, there are various options, like you can also change the format of the table. So either you can select auto format option to change the format. There are various formats available. You can select any format from here, or you can also select any table format by going to table properties. You have to go to table, click on table properties, and from here you can select any background color for your table, and you can also select any border style for your table. So I am selecting this. You can see the preview here. I am selecting all borders from here. Now you can see all the borders are coming. So these are the default styles which you can select and see the preview here. I am selecting the border style also and select the color of the border also from here. Okay, take any color which suits you and click on OK. So I have taken a background color and borders from table properties. So according to that, my table has been changed. So all these options are there in the table menu. So either you can use auto format or you can use table properties. You can also split a table. So like suppose my cursor is here on the second student's roll number and I click on split table. Okay, if you want to copy the heading also in the second table, then you can click on copy heading. So now the table, the same table is split into two parts. This is mark sheet table where my cursor was, the table was split from that side. So I'm pressing Ctrl Z for undo. Okay, so you can try out these options for your table. Similarly, you can also delete the entire table. If you place the cursor inside the table, you can also delete the entire table. So this is how you can give a heading by using merge cells option, inserting a row and give merge cells option. You can use split cells, you can insert, delete rows, columns. Okay, and you can also use table properties or auto format to change the background color of the table or change the border of the table.